It's amazing to me when you walk on the streets of America on a college campus that people perceive God to be bipolar. There's an Old Testament God and there's a New Testament God. God's schizophrenic. Brother, you guys are preaching the Old Testament God, not the New Testament God. He's giving you Bible verses in Revelation, that is New Testament. Yes. There are verses in the Bible that do talk about this.
Yeah.
God is not bipolar.
Amen.
Brother J.K., you know, there's a verse, red letters, in the book of Revelation, since we're so involved with God's love, let's be frank. Jesus said, "Those whom I love, I rebuke and chasten." Well, I don't see much rebuking and chastening. Perhaps God doesn't love us as much as we say. We're kind of like the red-headed stepchild. It's obvious God loved the Israelites. You did one thing, he took you out. He said, "Nobody touches that ark." Some man, when the ark fell down, he tried to grab it to save it. God struck him down. God wasn't cruel and mean. He just loved the Israelites. Well, in America today, we don't see much chastisement. So we don't have all this love that everyone claims to do. If he did, he'd be ripping up the streets.
Right.
He'd be destroying. It's red letters. "Those whom I love," I'm not going to give you a group hug.
Right.
"I'm going to rebuke you and chasten you. I'm going to be all over you like a drill sergeant." And so people are a little bit upset at our preaching. Wait till they meet the two witnesses that walk down the street. You know, we're actually paving the way for those guys. You don't like our message? Hey, they bring fire down from heaven. That's New Testament. That the Bible says that entire world was angry with these guys. They troubled the entire world, those two men. So they have issues with us. What are they going to do with these guys? J.K. mentioned about the throne of God. Wow. What an awesome thing. And again, unless you've stood in a courtroom, you really don't have a clue of what that's like. You know, it's good to have an attorney because he speaks on your behalf. You just sit there and keep your mouth shut. He does all your talking. If you actually get put on the stand, a good attorney is going to tell you, don't say much. Learn to say yes, no, and that's enough. The more you talk, the more you get questioned, the more you get indicted. But it is a bit intimidating. And if you read stories in the Bible where angels appeared to men, it's not like testimonies that you see here today.
Right.
"I saw an angel and, you know, we gave each other a high five and, hey bro, how you doing? He gave me a message." That's not biblical encounter. When angels that just left the throne of God contacted a human, those angels repeatedly said two words before they said, "Fear not." Because when you saw an angel just from the throne of God, not being in the throne itself, these people fell on their faces. They were shaken. It wasn't like they were your homeboy. These angels came, and when you saw these heavenly creatures, you fell on your face. I don't know how many testimonies I've heard. Yeah, I saw an angel and he said this and we communicated. I have to doubt that. Because most of the people in the Bible, even Mary, when the Virgin Mary met these angels, "Fear not." That's not even being in the throne of God. You are just in the presence of a being who left the throne of God. And so when the Bible says we can boldly come to God's throne,
hallelujah,
do we really understand what that Bible verse means? You know, we don't know what it's like to live within a king, where if a king says, make me laugh, and you tell a joke and you don't make him laugh, you lose your head. We have no concept of living under a king. So it's hard for us to grasp. We can actually come with boldness to God's throne. Wow. We don't understand that. I've never been to Bible college. I've read the Bible like you. But it doesn't take a genius to figure this stuff out. If an angel who left God's presence is going to make you kiss the pavement shaking like a little girl, imagine what's going to happen when we stand before God and His throne. It's an awesome sight. And so if God loves mankind or America the way most Christians are proclaiming, where's the chastisement? Where's the rebuke? That's Revelation. It's red letters. It's not Old Testament. It's red letters by Jesus. Those whom I love, I rebuke and chasten. So it's very tangible that God is raising up a large army of people to start rebuking. That's God's form of love. God's not looking down at Las Vegas with a tear in his eye. No. He's pretty upset. He's very angry. And so he'll use us to chastise, but nothing compared to the Israelites. Boy, God really loved them, because that's what he does when he loves you. A good father is going to correct his son. Well, when it's a stepson, I can't do that because mom may get upset. He handles a stepkid a little bit different. But his real son, he's going to go after, because he expects much out of him. We don't have that chastisement. If God loves us, as being echoed on the streets and the pulpits of America, there should have been a wrath coming down after the first abortion, after the first homosexual parade. Yes. They should not have gotten this far.
Yes.
So is it possible that God doesn't love us as much as we say? He loved us in the sense that he gave us his son. That's how God demonstrated his love. It was done in an act, the cross. He's not in heaven weeping, crying for your soul. That's an atheist that I've actually talked to on a college campus said, it doesn't make any sense. He loves me now, but he's going to put me in hell when I meet him. Yeah, it's a bit bipolar. At least we're a little bit more consistent. God is angry with the wicked every day. If God's going to put you in the hell now, he's pretty upset right now. If God's going to put you in the hellfire for all eternity, I'd say he's pretty angry right now.
Yes.
But to expound on God's love is chastisement, is rebuke. It's in the Bible. That same book that we consider holy. And so as J.K. gave you a rundown of God's wrath, I don't apologize for God. Your Christian today would have apologized for the flood. Your Christian today would have tried to rebuild the Tower of Babel and said, I'm really sorry my God did this to you. Your Christian today would have said, I am sorry my God destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. And those cities were not like Dallas-Fort Worth. They're not right next to each other. You had a large piece of real estate miles between these cities. And when God took them out, that's God's love. I had enough, and that's how he shows his love. He cleans it up. Your Christian today would have apologized. I'm sorry, maybe God had a bad hair day today. Excuse him, he's not always like that. No, I don't apologize for God. I actually reinforce what he says, because it's going to be a terrible thing to fall into the hands of the living God. That's Bible. I didn't put it in there. That's been in the Word of God. So when we go out and we talk about God's love, give the full character of God.
Yes.
And again, people say, Brother Reuben, you preach a lopsided message. It's a lot of hell and judgment and fire.
Yes, amen. Good job.
I will be the first one to admit that, because I'm trying to balance out your imbalance.
Yeah, right.
They don't see they're pushing too much of God's love. They just see us.
Right.
And again, every sinner that you're going to bump into in the street, it's not like they've not heard the death, burial, and resurrection. In America, we're very fat with the gospel. And so they need to be shaken up a little bit more. And if God loves America, there should be some judgment. As per, if I love you, I'm going to rebuke you and chasten you. I don't see much chastening. So obviously, we've been quenching God. There's not much of God showing his love other than he demonstrated his love. And again, that was God's love to mankind. There was works behind it. God demonstrated. He didn't just say, I love you. Jesus went to the cross. He didn't just say, I love you, Father. Jesus said, if you love him, obey him. There's works behind it. Those are what actual tangible make you that you love God. This is how much I love you, Father. So God demonstrated his love. That's why Christ died on the cross. But we need to give the full counsel of God. Right now, if you died, most likely would not be very good. The verses that we find in Revelation, Jesus Christ is speaking to seven churches. And that's the verse that he said, those whom I love, I rebuke and chasten. Seven churches. Five of those seven churches he told to repent. And that was early. Add 2,000 years to that, all the leaven, the heresies, the lies, the religious spirit. We're in real bad shape. And so we're not going to be preaching a very popular message. But let's understand, if we're going to tell them about the love of God, let's make it clear that God, when he destroys you and puts people into hell, that is a form of God's love. Not necessarily his judgment, and God's not schizophrenic. The same God of the Old Testament is the same God of the New Testament.